It's Wednesday, December 13th, and it looks like Apple CEO Tim Cook has finally found his wallet, and just in time for the holidays. Following the not wholly unexpected $400 million acquisition of music identification app Shazam on Monday, Apple has now dipped into its billion-dollar advanced manufacturing fund and infused specialized chipmaker Finisar with a $390 million investment. Finisar makes the specialized chips needed for Apple's Face ID system, the animoji feature, and the portrait tech used in the dual camera setup. So, important. The chiptech Finisar makes is known as vertical cavity surface-emitting lasers, and they're located in Sherman, Texas, just north of Dallas. CNET says the windfall will reopen a plant shuttered in 2012 and will bring 500 jobs to the city. To be clear, Apple isn't buying the company, just heavily investing in it. Apple made a similar investment into Corning, which makes the Gorilla Glass used in every Apple portable device. And for some perspective, if Apple's $250+ billion cash reserves were just $250, the investment into Finisar would come to 39 cents. Come on, Tim. Sony's just $55 and Tesla's $57. You should buy yourself both of them for Christmas. So, Star Wars fans, are you counting the minutes to Thursday's wave of midnight showings of The Last Jedi? Hey, we're right there with you. But you know who won't be in line for the latest edition of Lucas's space opera? People who are actually in space aboard the International Space Station. No worries, though, as NASA says the current residents of the ISS will indeed get a screening of The Last Jedi while on board their actual spaceship, which whips around the Earth every 90 minutes. According to spaceflight reporter Robin Simongold, NASA will upload the Death Star plans, or we mean the Last Jedi movie file, at a future date so the crew can enjoy it on a laptop or the station's video projector. Wait, the ISS has a video projector? Apparently so. And hey, if you're going to send something up to the space station, it may as well get its own patch. Here it is, and we love it. Hey, speaking of Star Wars, remember that little sub-theme in the original trilogy about how Luke loses his hand to Darth Vader and then gets this spiffy mechanical one like it's no big deal, except it makes him more like Vader? We love that part. Well, once again, actual science is catching up to science fiction. Take a look at Jason Barnes, a pianist who lost an arm in an accident 5 years ago. A team at Georgia Tech has fitted him with this fully articulating five-fingered prosthetic. And using some machine learning tech and a bunch of sensors, Barnes is back at the keyboard tapping out tunes. It's still a research project, but they're hoping to refine, miniaturize, and improve the design so that eventually it'll be a commercial product anyone can use. Maybe robots will install it as well. We can only hope. Check out the whole story and video at the link. And of course, go to digitaltrends.com for all the latest tech news. Check out our Facebook page and YouTube channel, and we'll see you again tomorrow. Thanks for watching.